more of this, because I can't think of a better intro. I don't know. Anyway, I was going to start off by doing that thing with Chunky, but I'm not going to because I don't think it'll be very orderly. I don't know. Anyway, I need to, like, I end up getting all the, like, different doors in this world mixed up, so I'm going to try to be systematic about it. I need to open that. That's usually where I go first. But I won't this time, but I will open the door. Oh, shit. I don't know why I'd, like, chicken out of shooting that. Did that not work? Motherfucker. Anyway, new Pokemon info was released today, or probably, like, tomorrow in Japan, since it was supposed to be at that time. But yeah, there's like a buttload of new Pokemon that they released, and I really fucking wish that they would like stop doing that so much. I know I already complained about this, but it's looking more and more like they're gonna just have the entire fucking Pokedex like given to you before the game is even out, and I'm like, let us find the Pokemon in the game when we play it, not before it even comes out, like, months before that. What the hell? These switches, Jesus Christ. You know what, maybe I will just go in here, because there's Funkies over here, and I can do this stupid banana with the apple. The stupid apple banana and tomato banana. Speaking of Pokemon and tomatoes, I'm currently growing a couple of tomato plants just sort of in a pot out back, and I named them Cherubi and Skiddo because they are cherry tomatoes, so the Cherubi makes sense, and Skiddo is just a good generic grass type name. By the way, that's homing ammo, it's stupid. You don't really need it, but whatever. But, since, like, I was a little kid and we were growing little potted plants in the house, we named them after grass-type Pokemon, and that was back when there was only, like, the original 150. So, can you stop fucking around, please? So, yeah, I was like, I need to give them Pokemon names, and so I did. No. What? Now I don't have this much trouble just squishing the damn tomatoes. Maybe because their hit detection is retarded. And he's like, take me to a place that's not here because it's raining, except not when the Chunky is huge. And Bruce, usually, there's that one purple banana that mocks you because it's in a fucking stupid place. Let's see, is it over here? Yes. And the dialogue appears from the corner, even though he's not in the corner. Anyway, yeah, that's like a really easy banana. And it's like way smaller than Chunky. And I know that they can change the sizes of the bananas, but whatever. Okay, so that's open, but I'm gonna go switch to Tiny because there's a bunch of bananas in there. Actually, there's three bunches. Come here, come here, come here. But yeah, I don't have any, like, plans for what I'm doing in this video, as you can clearly tell, because I'm just shitting around mostly. I mean, this game mostly consists of just shitting around in various creative ways, but... I'm adding a whole nother layer of shitting around to it. Perhaps you could even call it bullshittery. I can hear my dog snoring from the other fucking room. Good lord, Bailey, please breathe. And I just didn't jump there. That was cool. That's a nighttime door that I basically never open. I think there's, like, green coins behind it and a boss door. But it's like, has anyone ever gone to it? Because I don't think they have. Oh my god, what now? You, I guess. There's yellow bananas somewhere. Ignore the bee. I don't want to just keep talking about Pokemon because, like, that's not why people are watching this, but it's an easy thing to talk about. This isn't- okay. This is maybe the area I want to go to. I need to find Cranky in this level pretty quickly. Let's not travel in this because there's a bunch of blue shit and there's like a grape thing up there. Bees. Oh my god. There's like a new bee fly thing Pokemon. Someone on Tumblr said it was like a bee fly, or someone said it was a mosquito. I don't fucking know. Apparently its name is Cutie Fly, which is dumb. But meh. And then the fish Pokemon, it's water psychic, which is kind of neat, but why did they make it? It's fucking weird and ugly. Like, if you've played Brawl, it's like in the Subspace Emissary, those like plants that come out of the ground and kiss you and it fucking sucks. It's like that, but in fish Pokemon form. And it's like, why did you do this? That's not a tag barrel. Okay. That's a tag barrel, though. Whee! What other new Pokemon are there? Oh, there's the Pikachu ripoff, which is like a hedgehog, which sounds like a great idea, but then they gave it, a tail for no reason than other than to just look more like Pikachu. Like, just make it not have a tail. It doesn't need one. It's a hedgehog! So, yeah, I don't know. It's just... I mean, it's cute and everything, but it's sort of just like, I don't know why they're even making, like, Pikachu-type Pokemon still. Like, I was just saying this earlier and, like, on Facebook, but, like, back in the day, you had Pikachu, and Pikachu caught on. It's really popular, whatever. Whether or not you like it, that's how it happened. Then, second gen was, like, a direct sequel to the Kanto games. So you could excuse them making Meryl as, like, another Pikachu. Here's, Leafy Land, which is the greatest place in the universe. And also has a rabbit race that I'm not doing because it's impossible without glitching the game, apparently. But, like, so Meryl, and also the thing about Meryl is, like, it's actually fairly distinct from Pikachu. Like, I don't feel like I'm just using a cheap Pikachu knockoff every time I use it, and I've actually used it a couple times. And so, like, that's excusable. Then, with the Hoenn games, it's like, this isn't a direct sequel to the Kanto games anymore. We don't need any more Pikachu ripoffs. And then what do we get? Fucking two of them in that game. Yeah. Fuck you. He's sleeping with his fucking eyes open because he's dumb. Why can't I slam? Screw you. That new slam move we got. You know, and then fourth gen is like Pachirisu, and I don't like Pachirisu. It's fucking obnoxious. And then they made it even worse and made Emolga, which is just a flying version of Pachirisu, but it's even more annoying. And then they had Dedenne. I always say Dedenne because it's French, but then it's apparently Dedenne. I don't know. And it's okay. It's cute. It's fairy type. It's fairly distinct, but it's also just like, why are we still making the new Pikachus? Why are we still fucking doing that? Like, 20 years later. Please stop. Yeah, I'm not doing anything interesting in this video. Also, the owl shit, yeah, I'm not doing it either, because it's annoying as fuck. There should be a tiny thing here, though. I mean, I guess I am making progress if I'm just collecting bananas, but... like regular ones, since I don't need to get all the golden bananas. Quit. I'm gonna slam, damn it. I can get a couple bananas though. What I mean, and in my own mind, I count getting the blueprints as getting a banana because it counts for one. You just won't see me get it because it's just standing around watching a cutscene. Plus, this banana also leads to another one. In that other area I was in with the Apple guy that sells iPhones, clearly out of his house. Oh, I have to stretch. Good thing nothing important is going on. Also, I'm getting butt-fucked by the glare on two sides of the screen instead of the one in the middle, which is maybe worse, but I feel less disturbed by it. Because I'm recording this even earlier in the day than I did the other ones, and the bear is still very real, so. Yeah, this is basically just like murder all your friends for fun. They're not my friends. But yeah. And get a whole bunch of oranges. And there's a bean that just appears with no explanation whatsoever. Because crypticism is cool. Donkey Kong. Let's see, what else can I do in this video? I will do stop and swap in this video. Because, you know, it's obviously in this game. Apparently they were going to put, like, the ice key or some shit in this game, but they didn't. And just reused a bunch of music from other shit. Let's do the chunky thing, because it goes to the other area. And by the chunky thing, I mean the minecart ride, which I'm bad at, but... we gon' do it anyway, fam. Plus, there's regular bananas. I hold 5 of them. It's important. And there are coins back there. I thought they were bananas for a second, but I'm like, no, they're coins. That's why they're not important. Yeah, he's like, you need to get 50 coins and don't die. You can't die, but I don't think you can die on this. If you can, I don't know how to. I mean, theoretically, you could take a bunch of damage, but... actually, I don't know if you... no, you don't take damage. You lose coins, but you don't actually take damage. I'm already fucking this up big time. Big O time. I don't know why I said O. Reminds me how sometimes people on Tumblr say fucko, and it's way more funny to me than it should be. I really shouldn't keep talking about Tumblr, but I do spend a lot of time there. I like to think I'm better than most Tumblr people. Like, I'm not a raging fucking weirdo. I don't mean that disrespectfully to people on Tumblr, but like, I'm only gonna negatively refer to someone on Tumblr if they're actively being a dumbass. You know, being, like, not the status quo is not the point of contention. It's like people policing literally fucking everything that occurs to people that aren't in a minority of some sort. God damn it. I should be able to finish this with 50, unless I really take it in the ass. Beware the trees. Beware this thing. Which I never remember even paying attention to when I was younger, but now I have to, because otherwise I fuck it up. Like, sometimes I feel like I was way better at video games when I was a little kid and didn't know anything. Except, like, for times I remember specifically being really, really terrible. Like in Donkey Kong Country 3, the fucking, the, like, spider boss. For some reason, back in the day, I could not beat that thing in a reasonable amount of time, and now I'm just like, this sure is a boss. I hate Donkey Kong Country 3, mainly because the final boss is way too hard, but... this is the lake with lots of purple bananas in it, right? Can I look? Yeah, it is. I guess this isn't a lake, it's more like a moat, but it's a weird place for a moat. Let's go in here. I don't think I can actually do anything in here yet. Well, no, I can do the shit with the banana back there, but... or, that's not in this. That's in the other part. But I can't open this, and it'll show me a cutscene, because it's like, there's a hole you can uncover, and I'm like, I know. Like, this is the most pointless cutscene there is. Yep, this isn't it. This just turns on the water wheel, I think. It makes it rain and makes the water wheel thing. Make it rain, and that's a bunch of tiny shit in here. That bee was stuck on the thing. We're gonna ignore that. This was a waste of time going in this building. Sure never found anything worth a shit in that building, but along the way, we sure learned a lot about cuddling. That's a really obscure reference that nobody's gonna get except, like, 2 people. Maybe 3 people. This is the room I was thinking of, but I don't... Can you see the code from in here? Bailey, stop snoring so damn loudly. This bee is gonna piss me off. Nice little jingle from the triangle man. Is it 2-1-1-3-2. I guess I'll do it, whatever. Apparently you can clone this banana. I don't know how to, but for a while I always thought that I was getting something twice just on accident, but they're actually two separate bananas, because you get one for get up on the box. Oh my god! You get one for crushing the three steel barrels, but you also get one from doing this shit. Hopefully that bee doesn't respawn and eat my ass while I'm trying to get over here, because if I remember correctly, this gate closes obscenely fast for no reason. Maybe that was because I went in there, but I remember one time I didn't even fuck around, and I just, like, couldn't get in there. Okay, turn. Thanks. Bailey! I know you probably can't hear her, but she's, like, really loud. Exciting, pulling switches, action and adventure. Do it again. I'm surprised they didn't randomize this code. But again, this is not Banjo-Tooie where they randomize everything. Where's that bee? Watch its shadow shit itself. 2-1-3-2. And the funny thing is, I'm not even gonna be able to get this banana because you have to make it nighttime to even go in the cage. And the video is already pretty much over, so it's like, what can I do that's productive in the last 2 seconds of this? Probably nothing. So, yeah. I don't know why I switched to Chunky. Anyway, this was a stupid video, but thank you for watching anyway. Here's a stroke. Look at his hands.